Okay, children, so in the last class, we had discussed about the reaction of acids and bases with water, right? And we have learned that acids will produce H plus ions and the bases will be produced OH minus ions. But this H plus ions cannot exist alone. So they combine together with water molecules to form hydronium ions, right? Then there are certain questions in your textbook, page number 25, based on this portion. So we can discuss it now. All of you take your textbook, page number 25. Aditya, can you read the first question?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Page number 25.
I'm checking.
Okay. Meghna, can you read the first question? Aditya, you can read the second one, okay? Meghna.
Why do hydrochloric acid show characteristics in solutions, but solutions of compounds like alcohol and glucose do not show acidic characteristics?
Yes, the first question, why do HCl, HNO3, etc. show acidic characters in aqueous solutions, while solutions of compounds like alcohol and glucose do not show acidic character? What's the reason? Very good. Presence of H plus ions in acids. Acids can able to produce H plus ions. These H plus ions are charged particles. That's why acids can conduct electricity, while glucose... Page number 25. So you can write there. Presence of H plus ions. Okay. They are charged particles. Okay. Presence of H plus ions in acids. They are charged particles and able to conduct electricity. While glucose, alcohol, etc., they do not able to produce H plus ions. Even if hydrogen is there in that compound, but they cannot able to produce H plus ions. Only in the presence of charged particles, electricity can be conducted. Is this clear? Children, this is clear.
Ma'am, are you discussing question answers?
Yes. Page number 25. Finished?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Aditya, can you read the second question?
Why does an aqueous solution of an acid conduct electricity?
Yes, why does an aqueous solution of an acid conduct electricity? Can you tell me? All of you, please switch on your videos. Yes, what's the reason? Why do aqueous solution of acids conduct electricity? Yes, and Mary, can you tell me the reason?
Only in the presence of water, they can produce acidic nature H plus ions.
Very good. That's the reason. In aqueous solutions, in bracket, you can write in the presence of water.
Ma'am, did you give these notes printed?
I will give it after the completion of this chapter. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. In aqueous solutions, in the presence of water, acids can only able to produce H plus ions, which are responsible is responsible conduction of electricity. Okay, this is clear. Nirubamma, can you read the third question?
Why does dry HCl gas not change the color of the dry litmus paper?
Yes. Why does dry HCl gas not change the color of dry litmus paper?
Because we need a presence of water.
Once again,
Aditi? We need a presence of water.
Yes. In the case of dry litmus paper, water is not there, right? So in the absence of water, acids cannot able to produce H plus ions and no color change can be detected in dry litmus paper. That's the reason. So you can write there. In the absence of water, produce H plus ions responsible for the color change in litmus paper. Johan, can you read the fourth question? Johan, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, read the fourth question. Please switch on your video.
While diluting an acid, why is it recommended that the acid should be added to the water, not water to the acid?
And not water to the acid. What's the reason? Rifa, can you tell me?
Because it may give a splash and it is very harmful.
Yes.
Exposed heat and it may break.
Yeah, the container maybe breaks, right? So you can mark it there in the page number 24. It's there. Okay, the acid must always be added slowly to water with constant stirring. If water is added to concentrated acid, the heat generated may cause the mixture to splash out and cause burns. The glass container may also break due to excessive local heating. So you can mark there. Okay. Then, Adil, can you read the fifth question?
How is the concentration of hydronium ion H3O plus affected when a solution of an
acid is diluted. How is the concentration of hydronium ions affected when a solution of an acid is diluted? Can you tell me how is the concentration of hydronium ions affected when a solution of an acid is diluted?
Some of it will combine with water.
Yeah, Didi, once again.
Some of the hydronium ions will combine with water.
Yeah, here asking about the concentration. Is it increases or decreases?
Decreases.
Decreases, right?
Decreases.
Yes. On dilution, more water is added. So the concentration of H plus ions will be decreases compared to that of water. So you can write the decreases. Concentration of hydronium ions decreases. Write the...
What is the answer?
Decreases. Concentration decreases. Please switch on your videos. Surya, Savio, Afsana, Hadi Amin, Vishnu, Haya, Pratyush. Okay, Badra, can you read the next question? Sixth one.
How is the concentration of hydroxide ions affected when excess bases dissolved in a solution of sodium hydroxide?
Okay. How is the concentration of hydroxide ions affected when excess bases dissolved in a solution of sodium hydroxide? What happens?
Increases.
Yes, concentration increases. Then it will reach at a saturation stage. Okay, maximum stage. So you can write the concentration increases. Concentration increases. Okay, finished.
Yes, ma'am.
Do you have any doubt in this questions? Any question?
What is the last question,
sir? It's the concentration increases. Concentration increases. Then it will reach at a saturation stage. Okay. Any doubt in any questions?
Ma'am, the third question is slide. Can you show again?
Wait. Yes.
Okay.
Shall I move to next topic, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then we are going to learn about how to determine the strength of acids and base solutions. Okay. The strength of acid and base solutions. We have learned about indicators, right? What's the role of indicator? What's the function of indicator? To identify whether a substance is acidic or basic, right? Here we are learning about a universal indicator. Strength of acid or base can be estimated using universal indicator. We have learned about indicators, litmus paper, then phenolphthalein, methyl orange, turmeric. These all are examples of indicators. But here we are going to learn about a universal indicator. So the strength of acid and base both can be estimated using this universal indicator. Then this universal indicator, it's a mixture of several indicators. So it's a mixture of several indicators. And it shows different colors at different concentration of H plus ions in the solution. So here we are giving importance to this concentration of H plus ions. Okay, concentration of H plus ions. So here this universal indicator, it's a mixture of several indicators and it will shows different colors at different concentration of H plus ions in the solution. I told you there are different types of acids there, but the concentration of H plus ions is not same in all acids. So depending upon the concentration of H plus ions, not only in the case of acids, but also in bases, small amount of H plus ions there, but more OH minus ions. Okay. In the case of acids, more H plus ions. In the case of bases, more OH minus ions. But in bases also small amount of H plus ions there. So comparing with the concentration of this H plus ions, we can able to distinguish or determine whether it belongs to acidic one or basic one. And it will shows different colors at different concentration. In the case of acidic substance itself, it will shows different colors at different colors according to their concentration. Okay, we have learned that acids, they will shows blue litmus changes to red, right? But here in the case of this universal indicator, each acid will shows different color depending upon its H plus ion concentration. So you have to note down the point here. This based on the concentration of H plus ions. This universal indicator, it shows different colors at different concentration of H plus ions in the solution. This is just a model of that universal indicator. You can look here. These all are acidic substances, right? Gastric acid, that means the acid produced by stomach, then lemon juice, citric acid there, apple juice, malic acid there, tomato juice. Which one is the acid present in tomato?
Acid.
Which one?
Lactic acid.
No.
Malic acid.
Malic acid, yes, malic acid. So these all are acidic substances, but they show different colors depending upon their H plus ion concentration. Okay, depending upon the variation of H plus ion concentration, it will shows different colors. That's the difference between indicators and the universal indicator. Indicator just show if it is acidic, it shows a common color. If it is basic, it shows a common color. But here, this universal indicator, it will shows different colors depending upon the concentration of H plus ions. This is clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. And that universal, shall I move to next slide, children? Have you completed this one? Yes. Okay. So this universal indicator, it is known as pH scale. Okay. The name of the universal indicator, it is known as pH scale. You have to write P, small letter P, then capital H. Okay, pH scale, a scale for measuring H plus ion concentration in a solution. A scale for measuring H plus ion concentration in a solution. And this pH, in pH, the P stands for potens. Okay, potens. It's a German word, which means power. Potens, it's a German word. Its meaning is power. And in the pH scale, we can measure from 0 to 14. This is the range of pH scale. It starts from 0 up to 14. So this is the range shown by this pH scale. pH scale, it's a universal indicator. It's a mixture of several indicators. And we can determine the color change depending upon the H plus ion concentrations in different substances. So here this pH scale is scale for measuring H plus ion concentration in a solution. And this in pH, P stands for potens. It's a German word meaning power. And the range of this pH scale from 0 to 40. This is clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubt, anyone?
No, ma'am.
No. Okay. So can you tell me what about the pH scale of water from the 0 to 14? What
seven.
Will be? Very good. It's 7. Okay. All the neutral solutions will show the pH value 7. Then what about acids? Any idea? Yes, it's less than 7. And in the case of bases, it is greater than 7.
Up to 14.
Yes, up to 40. So if value of pH it is equal to 7, it is a neutral solution. 0 to 14 is its range. If the value of pH it is equal to 7, it's a neutral solution. If the value of pH is less than 7, it is an acidic solution. That means range 0 to less than 7. That means 0 to 6. You can write 0 to 7 because 6.5, 6.7, this also belongs to this category. So 0 to 7.
pH cannot be negative.
Yes.
pH cannot be negative.
pH value, right?
Yes.
No, never. It starts from 0 to 40. Okay. It's always positive. Then if value of pH is more than 7, it is a basic solution. Okay, it's a basic solution. That means 7 to 14. That's the range of basic solution. 7 for neutral solution, 0 to 7 for acidic solution, 7 to 40 for basic solution. So less than 7, it's acidic. Then okay, so we are going to learn how this hydronium ion concentration or H plus ion concentration related to the pH value. Okay, so here, higher the hydronium ion concentration, lower is the pH value. Because this hydronium ion concentration, it's related to acidic substances, right? I told you they will produce H plus ions and combines with water molecule to form hydronium ions. That is H3O plus ions. And bases will produce OH minus ions, right? So here, higher the hydronium ion concentration, that means the substance will be acidic. The pH value is lower. Clear? Higher the hydronium ion concentration, lower is the pH value. That means it belongs to acidic substances. Belongs to acid. Okay? And higher the hydronium ion concentration, hydroxide ion concentration, higher is the pH value. Because the hydroxide ion concentration increases, it will become a base, right? So here, it belongs to base. So these are the two things. Higher the hydronium ion concentration, lower is the pH value. If lower the hydronium ion concentration, higher is the pH value. Clear? And one more thing, higher the hydroxide ion concentration, higher is the pH value. This is clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Have you completed this slide, children?
Yes.
Yes, any doubt? Anyone? Okay, so higher the hydronium ion concentration, lower is the pH value. Then higher the hydroxide ion concentration, higher is the pH value. Then after that, there is one activity in your textbook, activity 2.11. Here you have to test the pH values of solutions, but we cannot do it in our homes. Whenever you reach here, we can do it in our lab. Okay, so I will send you the solution or that table 2.2 with your notes. Okay, so you can just go through that and we can understand the color of pH paper and the approximate pH value. Clear? This is clear, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So now let me check your attendance. Just wait. After this portion, there is one topic, importance of pH in everyday life. You can also read that portion.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So we can discuss the remaining portions in the next class. Okay. Thank you all. See you in the next class. Bye.
Thank you.
Thank you.